A total of 482 students from the Elgon sub-region have graduated from the presidential skilling hubs, marking a significant step towards reducing unemployment among the youth in the area. Punctuated with a heavy downpour this morning, youth at Elgon sub-region state hub graduated in various disciplines at Lukonge sub-county in Imbale district. The graduates, who included school dropouts and students from vulnerable families, completed 6 months intensive training in various vocational fields such as bricklaying and construction, carpentry, welding and metal fabrication, and tailoring, among others. Jen Bareche, the State House Comptroller, highlighted the importance of vocational training in addressing unemployment and empowering the youth.
Even if you go out of the country and you go to other countries, this certificate is recognized. Please clap for the ministry.
Fred Wanakina, an official from the Directorate of Industrial Training, conferred 482 professional certificates to graduates in their respective disciplines.
Don't say, I've gotten a paper, then you just go home and then misuse it. So you make sure you keep those certificates well. You can use them to get jobs, or you can also create your own jobs.
The graduation has been witnessed by Bamasaba Culture Institution leader Jude Mike Mudoma, Mbale Diocese Bishop John Nanda, political leaders, among others.
For sustainability of these projects, we need new approaches to financial inclusion to ensure that these brilliant ideas, this skilling, which are being well executed here in this region, have access to capital. If this is done properly, we will really begin to see prosperity unleashed in a broad sense in all corners of Uganda.
The industrial hubs in Lukonge sub-county in Imbale district was established to skill youth in the informal sector, providing them with practical skills that can lead to gainful employment. Today, officials from Twaweza, a national representative, Haile Frenkwe's mobile phone panel survey, unveiled a report finding on climate change in Uganda. This follows a recent survey carried out by the organization in the country. While presenting the findings to stakeholders, including members of the press at Makerere University College of Engineering, Marie Nanyanzi, the program coordinator, revealed that Ugandans have expressed great concern about the effects of climate change, which has consequently impacted on their livelihood.
Here we see that the majority of the citizens report that climate change is a concerning problem. We see that 86% say that they're concerned, and it's getting worse. Those that are saying it's getting worse are 57%. There is a consensus among Ugandans that climate change is an immediate issue impacting their lives.
According to the report, Ugandans have advocated for more initiatives to be adopted so as to reduce the effects of climate change. Among the recommendations they made was planting of trees and adoption of green technologies across the country. During the same meeting, which media practitioners and journalists were tipped on how to report effectively on environment-related stories. Climate change is a global crisis, but one where the impacts are first felt locally. Changing weather patterns, high temperatures, less predictable rain, and more frequent extreme weather. An enterprising mechanic in the East African nation of Burundi, Yves Mpawenayo, has potentially low-cost, environmentally friendly solution to the public transport and fuel shortage headaches facing his country's capital, Bujumbura, by creating an electric vehicle. His EV prototype is the first such invention in Burundi, local media reports say, and has helped him earn a certificate of merit from the country's president this week. Inspired by transport problems and lack of fuel, and that even when it is available, it is expensive. Yves Mpawenayo, the founder and director of the Electromaker, thought of making an electric car. He says first, he wanted to reduce the air pollution that harms the atmosphere because cars that use fuel emit a lot of pollution, and thought that electric cars could help reduce this air pollution that harms the atmosphere. According to Mpawenayo, research is complete and his company is on the verge of scaling up the production.